In this first video, we are going to look at the main structure of the brachial plexus. This is a complex area of anatomy, but we are going to start with the basics and add in the detail in a further video. To start with, watch as I draw the basic structure. Don't skip, just watch. Before we start, I'm going to put in the numbers of the spinal nerves we are dealing with, so that the right side of the page is medial and the left is lateral. This is the core of what you need to know. 10 lines on a page. Let's divide up the plexus into more manageable chunks. The brachial plexus can be divided into 5 sections: the roots, trunks, divisions, cords, and terminal branches. The brachial plexus has its origin in the anterior rami of spinal nerves C5, 6, 7, 8, and T1. You'll notice that the nerve C8 seems odd as there are only 7 cervical vertebrae. However, vertebra C7 has 2 spinal nerves associated with it, nerves C7, which emerges superiorly to the vertebra, and C8, which emerges inferiorly. These roots combine to form the 3 trunks. These are named the superior, middle, and inferior trunks. There's not much else to say about the trunks, so we'll move on. The divisions at first look complicated, but they are not. All 3 trunks send projections posteriorly to form a new nerve, here, which we will discuss in a minute. At the same time, the middle trunks sends an anterior projection here to form this amalgamation. All this crossing over leads to the formation of the 3 cords. The lateral cord is formed as we just described, and the posterior cord is similar. The medial cord is here. Finally, we reach the terminal branches. There are 5 terminal branches to remember, 3 anteriorly and 2 posteriorly. In a dissected specimen, the 3 anterior branches can be located by finding this M-like structure. From medial to lateral, the branches are the ulnar nerve, which broadly speaking innervates some of the medial extrinsic and intrinsic flexors of the hand, the median nerve, which innervates many of the lateral flexor muscles of the hand, and the musculocutaneous nerve, which innervates the muscles in the anterior compartment of the upper arm. Posteriorly to these nerves, we have the 2 posterior terminal branches. The first is the radial nerve. This nerve runs down the posterior arm to innervate all the muscles in the posterior compartments of the upper and lower arms. In this way, it is responsible for almost all extension in the arm and hand. The second is the axillary nerve. This curves off the posterior cord and runs under the glenohumeral joint to innervate the deltoid and teres minor muscles. These terminal branches provide motor, sensory, and sympathetic innervation to the arm and hand. The exact spinal root values for each of the branches is up for some debate, but a rough guide will be posted in the description. That's it for the overview of the brachial plexus. Join me in the next video to examine the more detailed features of this fascinating structure.
Subscribe to Soton Brain Hub for more videos to help explain the mysteries of the brain.